What is going on, guys? This is Robin, and we are 1 year post-surgery. Well, actually, it's on the 23rd of May, but I just thought I'd make the video now and give you guys an update of where I stand. So, it's been 1 year now, guys. Kind of the summary, as you guys can go through the past videos, but kind of summary is, took me roughly three months. So I can kind of start doing stuff again. Within 3 months of my surgery, I went to Europe and had a Europe trip. So that was a lot of sitting down at the time. There was a lot of discomfort. Shortly after that, I started working out slowly, obviously. Within the 4 months after that, I posted a video. Or I'm going to post it at the end of this. We'll see. But it's pretty much what happened, guys. I started working out slowly, and I still had leg pain. And I started working more out, obviously, and the pain lessened a lot. In terms of like strength, I feel strong again. Doing a lot of the movements I was doing before, obviously I'm not performing any type of crunches just because that gives me a lot of discomfort. And in terms of like working out, I feel like I'm lifting heavy again. I'm not squatting, I'm not deadlifting, guys. I would say that just irritates my back. And I do belt squat, so I don't barbell squat. I actually barbell squat last week, which I'll post in a video series. That was the first time I squatted in over 2 years since the injury happened. And, you know, because squatting is the main movement that actually took me out of the game. And it was nice. There was actually no discomfort when that happened, but I just don't want to go down that road again. Maybe once I start fortalizing my core a bit more, I can possibly touch that exercise again and possibly deadlifts, but that's definitely not in the plans right now. But that's kind of where I'm at, guys. For anyone that's really thinking about getting the surgery, make a pros and a cons list. I know the pain's something else. For people that don't experience sciatic pain or back pain, or both, they really don't know what you're talking about. Sometimes they even think like you're kind of over-exaggerating what's going on, but that's not the situation. I remember that kind of took the different course in my life, as I don't know if I mentioned this in my past videos. When this happened, I was going to go take a semester abroad in Italy, and I blew out my spine, obviously, and that just kind of took me out of the game. I had to take 1 year of recovery And during that 1 year of recovery, like, I barely got any better. So that's what kind of led me towards the surgery. And I tried to do everything to avoid the surgery, guys. I did chiropractic care, all kinds of chiropractors, decompression, spinal decompression therapy, DRX 9000, physical therapy, you name it, guys, acupuncture, anything. But this was, I think, possibly one of the best decisions I could have made. So again, for anyone that's really thinking about getting the surgery, just really think about how much value this can bring, because essentially you are taking a part of your foundation out. So my disc was L5-S1. So I guess if you look at it in the house structure, it is the whole foundation, and they took a part of the foundation out. So, you know, at the end of the day, it was almost around, I think it was 9 or 11 millimeters out, which was crazy. And it was pinching on my left sciatic nerve. And sometimes I think, you know, the pain I'm having now is just because it was pinched for so long. It was over a year and a half. So that's kind of where I stand now, guys. It's 1 year post-surgery, and I'm posting all these videos about working out. If you guys, you know, can leave a like, share this with people that are going through the same situation, just because I know when I was looking for like solutions on YouTube or any type of social media, there wasn't really a lot of stuff in terms of working out and people actually like recording what they were doing. So that's why I decided to take this this road. So if you guys can share this with people, that'd be amazing, guys. Obviously, you guys can comment down below what you guys would like, because I don't know exactly what you guys are looking for in terms of maybe how my recovery is going now. What am I doing now? You know, I'm doing rack pulls now, which is really nice behind the back. Just doing a lot of exercises that I used to do back in the day. So it's just really nice, guys. I hope this helps. It's 1 year now. It's pretty crazy. So for anyone that's going through the same situation, I know where you guys have been at, but looking at this 1 year, I think it was possibly the best decision. So I'm going to play this video, and right now at the end of the of my little speech here. And hope you guys enjoy it. If you guys have any questions, please message me, leave a comment below. Anything that you guys want me to make some videos about, because I do also do foundation training. I'm doing chiropractic work. Like, I still have a decompression table right here in my bed, or bedroom, I mean. So just let me know, guys, and I hope these videos really helped you. And I'm obviously not gonna stop anytime soon, so just leave a comment below on what you guys want. I'll get back to uploading these type of videos. And thank you, guys. 1 year surgery. Here's the video in 3, 2, 1. Let's get it, guys.
What's up, everybody? Just want to say surgery was successful. I'm still kind of chilling here. Got all this stuff kind of just kind of woke up. I was very fuzzy yesterday after the surgery. But thank you for everyone's support from the bottom of my heart. Thank you, guys.